This exhibition is called All the Time in the World. It's from a Louis Armstrong song. I got the title, and I like that because it's kind of a bit cliched, but it's also quite profound if you think about it a bit more. And so I've got various representations of time. The works are quite photographic, and a photograph captures an instant in time. But also I've put various counterpoints of different times. So there's one painting which has the mountain range, and then it has an aeroplane in the sky. You can see the vapor trail of an aeroplane, and in the foreground you can see footprints through the snow. And they're three representations of time. Geological time, which is millions of years. It's a bit beyond our capability to understand. And there's the vapor trail, which represents how we can travel the world now quite easily in a short space of time. And then there's the footsteps, which are, you know, the most fundamental kind of representation of human movement through the world.
Better than I ever even knew. They say that the world was built for two.
This is the first show I've done in black and white. There's something fantastic, I think, about putting multiple different images into the same monochromatic cast, so that they're all part of the same universe. Even though you may not know what the connections are, the connections may not be obvious, but you can see that they're all part of a narrative. And I like to think of all the images together forming a sort of a filmic montage, really. I mean, you may not know what it's supposed to mean, but it's it's telling you something, definitely.
All I think of, watching all our friends fall in and out of all applause. This is my idea of fun.
So I'm always looking for an image that I want to paint, really. And I don't really mind where they come from. I mean, I like it when I take the image myself. I prefer that. But sometimes I just find images that I want to paint. Sometimes I find images and I combine them. And make an image, one image from several different photographs, and it's always a fantastic challenge trying to work out how to translate that image, a photographic image, into paint. That's part of the excitement for me.
They say that the world was built for two.
What attracts me to a photograph is often a tonal quality, the contrast, the subject matter. The light, it's a combination of many things. It's the formal elements. I mean, I begin with, say a mountain. A mountain's kind of an exciting image to me because when you stand in front of a mountain, it's on a scale that's so immense that it's hard to know how far away it is, for example. It's hard to relate it to your own insignificant size. But then pretty soon, as I start trying to think about how I'm going to paint it, I break it down into little shapes like a jigsaw and then take them apart, put them back together again. So I'm always going back and looking at my paintings and changing my mind about what attracted me to them in the first place. So I think there's some kind of timeless element that I'm attracted to in the pictures too. I want them to stand outside of time, and I want them to say new things every time you look at them. Yeah, cinema is a very big source of inspiration for me, and I do love old film noir. The cinematography in film noir is particularly attractive. I mean, they were such craftsmen, those cinematographers, getting the lighting exactly right, and the different shades of black and white too, which is something that you don't always think about. I did a lot of black and white photography when I was at art school. Spent a lot of time in dark rooms and found that there are several different grades of black and white, from kind of bluish blacks and whites through to warm browny silvery tones. And the film still, in particular, in comparison to a photographic image, it seems to, sometimes it has a slight blur. It captures a sense of movement of the because it's 24 frames a second. It's part of a sequence of moving images, and there is that sense of movement which I like, and I try to put that into the work. There's often a soft blur to the edges of everything that I paint. But the other thing is, the film still is, it gives a hint of a bigger narrative, doesn't it? It, it captures a moment in time where there's definitely something's happened before and there's definitely something going to happen afterwards.
Get over here and play a video game.
I do like sci-fi films too, in particular, from the 50s. I like the design of the flying saucers in those. And I also like, there's something about the amateur UFO photography, which is also quite nice because that's always blurry. And I don't believe in UFOs. I don't have a problem with there being life elsewhere in the universe. I certainly hope there is. But I just love the contrast of something otherworldly with something very worldly. And that's obviously another time kind of shift as well when you think of the light years that it would take for a UFO to get here compared to an old shack, for example, in this show, which is probably, 100 years old at most. I find roads very enigmatic, and a lot of my work is based on travels, which obviously you do on roads, but the road is a kind of universal metaphor too. It's it represents time in terms of the same way as our life can be seen as a journey from beginning to end. And I particularly like roads that curve in my paintings, because that's sort of that's like life too. We don't know what's around the corner, especially when they disappear into the darkness. It's like we can only see as far as the headlights will allow us to see. And they're kind of mesmerizing.
Have fun playing video games. It's you, it's you.